Steve Ross has led an amazing life. Liberated from a Nazi concentration camp by American soldiers, he came to Boston where he worked with at-risk youth and became a driving force behind the creation of the New England Holocaust Memorial. Now he's the subject of the documentary Etched in Glass, The Legacy of Steve Ross.
When I was 9 years old, Germany invaded Poland. I was incarcerated in 10 slave labor death camps.
It was relentless for 5 years. One time I stole a potato. A guard saw me and he gave me 25 lashes with a lead pipe. Several times I was going to be murdered, but I managed to get away.
I can't fathom like all the stuff you went through.
Me too.
After I was rescued from hell, I came upon a soldier that showed me compassion and he gave me a flag.
America brought me here and they said I'm human.
I didn't have a penny.
I had no place to live, but I lived in the car when I attended Boston University.
But I made something of myself and you can do the same thing.
Steve was a social worker in the projects, probably around the time I was just starting to get in trouble.
When I was about 14, I had stolen a car. That was the catalyst that brought Steve Ross into my life.
He made you feel important.
I was just amazed that he was even alive and decided to devote his life to helping kids like us.
And to see somebody actually here, you know, it reaches me, you know?
It is vital to have a memorial, to tell the world of all the atrocities.
In proposing this Holocaust memorial, Steve was the quarterback of the team.
The six towers was also the number 6 million. The six-pointed star, the six death camps.
I just want to show you the little flag that was given to me by a soldier.
That's what he gave him. He gave him a flag.
I have searched for this angel for many years.
If this really is my grandfather, he's been searching for 67 years.
Don't give up your education. Stick with it.
And joining me now, Roger Lyons, producer and director of Etched in Glass, in quite a film, quite inspirational. And I know that Steve has had some health challenges. How's he doing?
He's doing pretty well for a 92-year-old Holocaust survivor. He's been battling all sorts of illnesses throughout his life, really, since the Holocaust. But he just celebrated his 92nd birthday, and he's hanging in there.
And you put a lot of time into this film. What was it about Steve's story that you found so compelling?
He has so much energy and conviction. When I talked to him for the first time, when I actually was introduced to him, I had a 2-hour phone conversation with him, and he went through his entire life story. Mm-hmm. And it just was remarkable. And then I did an interview. The first thing I did with him on camera was at the memorial, the Holocaust memorial. And just, it was so compelling. He just really got to me. Plus the fact that Holocaust denial was really kind of reaching a peak back then. In fact, it's revived, unfortunately. And what I wanted to do was capture Steve and what he was saying about what really happened. And keep it for posterity, really, if nothing else.
And tell us about the process of putting a film like this together. So many emotions involved.
It's really amazing. I was actually assigned to do a 60-second piece on unsung heroes and so forth. And somebody suggested, a friend of mine, Ren Ross, not a relation, said, why don't you call Steve Ross? He's a perfect person to be doing this profile of. And it turned out he was. He's just the most amazing person, so inspiring. Just to hear him speak, it's just amazing. And he doesn't really do it anymore because he's had health issues. But when he spoke to young people, he spoke with such conviction and so forth, and pushing for tolerance and things like that. I just had to do something as long as a documentary, not that 1-minute piece that I talked about a minute ago.
Yeah, and as we see in the film, he goes around and speaks and shares his stories at many schools. What type of reaction has he gotten?
It's really remarkable because what he did for years and years and years was talk about what he went through, all the things he suffered through, and how he made it through 10 concentration camps over a 5-year period as a kid, really. And so when he told people at the former Boston High School and at the Burke School in Dorchester, when he told these kids his story, they kept thinking, well, if this guy can get through what he got through and come out on the other side, I could do it too. Whether I have, you know, these kids had drug issues and abuse and alcohol and crime and so forth, but they were inspired to pull through themselves by Steve.
All right, really quickly, where can people see this film?
It will be at various places around New England. If you go to steverossfilm.org, our website, we'll have a listing of all the screenings in the area.
Perfect. Roger Lyons, thank you so much, and we'll be right back.